Today we'll be talking about plasma, an Ayurvedic formulation. When a drug is heated, it converts into black colored substances which produces smoke, and if further heating continues, then it converts into the grayish or white colored substances, we call it ash. And the black colored substance with no smoke is called as mushy formulation. But if we take a drug and we treat the drug with some herbal juices or whatever the mention in the Ayurvedic text, we call it the Bhavana Dravya. So when we take a drug and treat with the Bhavana Dravya, and now if we apply heat, then it converts into Bhasma formulation. So the process of conversion of, or the formation of Bhasma from drug means metals or minerals, is called as Bhasmikara. We have to do some samskara to the drug to convert into Bhasma. The objectives of this samskara are elimination of harmful material from the drug, or elimination of harmful matter from the drug, modification of undesired physical properties of the drug, conversion of some of the characteristics of the drug, and enhancement of the therapeutic action of the drug. So the states involved in Bhasmikaran are Shodhana, Marana, Bhavana. Shodhana literally means purification. Marana means killing, and Bhavana means processing. So these are the three states involved into Bhasmikaran processes. And what do we need for this? We need Shodhana Dravya, we need Bhavana Dravya, we need a Khalva for graturating it, we need Sarav Samput. These are earthen pots, shallow earthen pots, cow dung cakes, then Multani Mitti for sealing the edges of this earthen pot, and we need a peat for puta, means to apply agni. So we'll be talking about Shodhana. There are two types of Shodhana, Samanya Shodhana and Vishesh Shodhana. Samanya Shodhana means this is a particular class of drug. This class of drugs are, all the class of drugs can be purified by the same way. And Vishesh Shodhana, where a particular method is given as per Ayurveda for purification of the drug. And there are various methods of Shodhana, like Prakshalana means washing. So whatever the physical impurities are there, sand, clay, adhering on the drug, it can be washed. That is called as Prakshalana. Chalana means sifting. Clay, sand, if present in the drug, it can be removed by Chalana. Svaka Nishikansa means removal of the skin from the fresh fruits. Then Nimajana means keeping or soaking a drug into Shodhana Dravya for 24 hours, or it may be 6 or 10 days as per the Ayurvedic test. So soaking the drug in the Shodhana Dravya is Nimajana. Then Nirapna, this is applicable to the metals like gold, silver and copper. These are heated on flame till they become red hot and are immediately immersed into a Shodhana Dravya. Then Urdhvapatan, it's sublimation, and this is a diagram shown here in the Urdhvapatan. The first, this is the Urdhvapatan. Here two earthen pots are taken. This is one earthen pot and this is inverted position, second earthen pot. The drug is kept into the lower earthen pot, and the edges of these earthen pots are sealed with the Multani Mitti, and a cloth smeared in Multani Mitti is wrapped around the edges of this earthen pot, and it is sealed, and then fire is applied. So the vapors are formed and it goes here on the top of this inverted earthen pot. We have to keep the wet cloth, so condensation will happen and these vapors will get condensed here in the inner side of the upper earthen pot. So this is Urdhvapatan, its sublimation process. Then Adhapatan, this is Adhapatan. Here we need to make a peat in a soil, and in this we have to place the earthen pot. So the neck will be above the peat, and the remaining part will be in the peat. And then the second earthen pot we have to keep in inverted position same as what we did in the Urdhvapatan. But here in this case, the lower Ardhan pot will be having water, and the upper part at the inner side of this upper Ardhan pot, we have to keep the drug. Then we have to seal the edges with the Multani Mitti, and cow dungs are kept here, and fire is applied. Lit the fire, and then this will melt, and it will fall into the in this water in the lower Ardhan pot. So this is Adhapatan and Triyakpatana. Here we have to take the two Ardhan pot, and the hole is connected. Here one hole is there, here another hole, a pipe is placed in between, they are connected, and these Ardhan pots are covered with the lid. Drug is kept into this Ardhan pot, and fire is applied, so vapors will form, it will go here, and it will get condensed here. This Ardhan pot is kept in a plate which is filled with water, so this will be the cool environment, and with this there will be a condensation. So Urdhvapatan, Adhapatan and Trikayapatana is generally carried out for the dasat purification, mercury purification. So as already we have seen, we need a Shodhana Dravya, we need a Bhavana Dravya, we need Khalava, that is mortar and pestle, we need Sarav Sampu, that is Ardhan pot, cow dung cakes, Multani Mitti and pit for puta. So some of the example of Shodhana for making of Abrak Bhasma, Mika Bhasma. Heat the piece of Mika till they become red and deep into the decoction of Trifala or Kanji or cow's urine or cow's milk. And we have to repeat this process for 7 times. For Shodhana of Abraka, this is given by the Ayurvedic taste. Other method for the same Abraka Bhasma, making Shodhana process, heat the piece of Mika till they become red and quench into Nirgundi Swarasa. And this we have to repeat for 7 times. So different Ayurvedic books and that they have mentioned different processes for the Shodhana or the Marana. For making of Kukurandhatvak Bhasma, that is a Bhasma of eggshell. The eggshells are put into warm water or in the buttermilk or in the Sendav Jala, that is rock salt water. And it can be from 1 day to 6 days. The period is mentioned as per the Shodhan Dravya which we are using. If you are using warm water, buttermilk or Sendav Jala, the duration changes. Then preparation of Hartala, that arsenic trisulfide. Kushamanda Swaras is mentioned, which is from the Benikasa Hispida, and it is done in the Dola Yantra. Dola Yantra means we have to take the Ardhan pot, and then this arsenic trisulfide is kept in one bag and tied properly, we call it potli, and then hang this potli into this that Ardhan pot. It will be filled with the Kusamanda Swaras, and then this potli is deep into this Swaras, and we have to keep it for 3 years. We have to apply fire, so boiling will be there of this Kusamanda Swaras, and then the purification of this arsenic trisulfide or the Hartara will happen there. So we have to keep it for 3 years. So once Shodhana is done, we have to dry the material, and then we have to do the Bhavana. Means we have to treat it with some herbal juices or whatever the mention in the Ayurvedic text. For example, if we are making Kukutandhatvak Bhasma, that is Bhasma of hen eggshell, Changeri Ras or Aloe Vera juice is mentioned. So what we have to do, we have to take the the purified substances, like we will be taking the purified eggshells now. We have purified it with the warm water or buttermilk or Sendav Jala, and then after drying it, we will triturate it, and now in this we will be adding the aloe vera juice or Changeri Ras, right? We have, as per the text, either we will be using Changeri Ras or aloe vera juice, and then mix it properly, and then we have to dry it. So either we can directly dry it, or we have to make the small pellets of it. It's called as chakrika, and we have to keep it and let it dry for some time. Once the drying happens, then we'll be moving for the marana process. Then second is arsenic trisulfide hartara. Here palash mula we have to take, and this palash mula we have to prepare the its quark we have to prepare. It is called as madhu sadrusha quark means it is similar like honey. And then three times we have to take this arsenic trisulfide and treat it with this madhu sadrusha quark, dry it, then again treat it with the same quark, dry it, and again treat with the same quark. And once it is done, we have to treat it with maish mudra, and we have to dry it again, and then we have to keep it for, we have to make the chakrika and we have to dry it. So in case of these three times, we need to do the bhavana, and then one with the maisha mudra, and then we have to dry it. So one shodhana is done, we have given the bhavana, and now we'll go for marana process. So marana process means, as I said, it is a killing. There are the marana process should be carried out in pit. So as per Ayurveda, there are different putas are mentioned, like Mahaputta, Gajaputta, Kukutaputta, Varahaputta, Laguputta. Likewise, the putas are mentioned, and the dimensions of putas are mentioned, and maximum temperature, how much it is going to attain, that is given here. So maximum Ayurvedic formulations, they are this bhasma are prepared in Gajaputta. The size is like 57 by 57 by 57 for Gajaputta. And this data is taken from the Journal of Ayurvedic and Herbal Medicines 2017. So this is a puta, a peat is prepared, and cow dungs are kept. So 2/3 cow dungs are kept at the bottom, and then this is the earthen pot. We have taken earthen pot here, one earthen pot, and then we'll be keeping the chakrika in this earthen pot, and we are keeping the other earthen pot in the inverted position, and the edges will be sealed by the multani mitti, and after drying this multani mitti, will be keeping it over it the over on a cow dung, 2/3 cow dungs which we have kept, as we can see here. So these cow dungs are kept here. This is the seal earthen pot containing the chakrika, and then the remaining cow dungs are kept over it, and then apply or lit the fire. So once everything burn, let it be swangshit, allow it to cool, and after that remove it. So after cooling it, open it, and we'll be getting the powder drug, and again we need to give bhavana. So whatever the time we have, the bhavana is mentioned that we have to give. So for example, if we are making Kukutantatva Bhasma, this Gajaputta, we have to repeat this process 7 times. So this will be one putta. Then we'll be taking the drug out, and again we are giving the treatment with aloe vera juice or changeri ras as per the text, and we will allow it to dry. Then we'll make a chakrika, and we'll keep in the other earthen pot where the chakrikas are kept. It is covered by the inverted earthen pot. We are going to seal the edges of it, and again we'll put into Gajaputta where 2/3 cow dungs will be kept at the bottom. Then this earthen pot and remaining cow dungs over it, and again lit the fire. So this will be after swangshit, we'll remove it. This will be second putta, and likewise we have to repeat the process 7 times. So these are the traditional methods of evolution. Nishavadu, avami, varitara, nirdhoma, rekapurna, lagu, sukshma, shlakshna, nishachandra, apurna bhava, Unama, Amla Pariksha, and Danta Grek Kachi Kachitatva. So Nisavadu means it should not have any taste. Avami, it should not cause emesis. Varitara should not float. It should float on water. Nirdhoma, when placed on fire, should not give out smoke. Rekhapurna, when placing finger between the index finger and thumb, it should enter in the lines of the finger. Lagu means light. Sukshma means it should be very fine powder. Slakshna means it should be smooth. Nishachandra, it should not have any shiny particle. Apurna Bhava should have permanent transformation. There should not be any remaining part of the original drug. Unama means when we keep the drug. In Varitara, we saw that this bhasma should float on water, and if we keep the rice grain over this water, then it should not sink. It should be there on the bhasma. So rice grain should be there. Then Amla Pariksha, here we have to take the curd, and in this curd we have to add bhasma, and the color of curd should not change. And same with the lemon. So there should not be any transformation or changes should happen in the curd or lemon in which we are mixing the bhasma. And Danta Gre Kachi Kachi Tattva, when we take in between the teeth, it should not create the sound. And modern methods we are using, like FTIR, DSN, XRD. This is just an example of Kukutan Tattvak Bhasma. This is the FTIR of shell. And this is after Marana, first Puta. And this is after 7 Puta. So we can see the sharp peak here. We can see the changes here. So at 1 Puta and 7 Puta, we can see the sharp changes. So changes are happening in the original drug while converting into bhasma. So we can go for FTIR, DSC and XRD for the evaluation of the bhasma. Thank you.